Morning students, how are you all? I hope all of you are keeping fine. A hearty welcome to today's English class. Today we are going to learn the fourth lesson from the Behind a Truly Beautiful Mind. It is about Albert Einstein. He was a great genius, a great scientist. He was born on March 14, 1879, in a German city of Ulm. When he was born, his head was unusually big, so his mother thought that he was a freak. Freak means abnormal, unusual, or that meaning. Then, until the age of 2 and a half, he was not able to speak. And when he started speaking, he started uttering twice each word. And he was not interested in any of his playmates. He loved to spend his time alone when he was small. So his friends called him Brother Boring. And he was fond of mechanical toys. And when his sister was born, he asked his mother, where are her wheels? He was not very happy during his school life, and he had to change his school. But at the age of 21, he completed his studies and he started working. He got an award in physics in 1921. He was very much interested in maths and physics. The title of the lesson, A Truly Beautiful Mind, we can say that he had a truly beautiful mind because he had a humanitarian attribute, and he advocated world peace, democracy, and disarmament. He became a politician and he worked for a world peace. He is known as a visionary and a world citizen. So students, take your textbook, page number 46. A Truly Beautiful Mind. Who do you think of when you hear the word genius? Who is a genius? What qualities do you think a genius has? So when you think a person as a genius, who is a genius? A genius is an exceptionally intelligent person. So Albert Einstein was an exceptionally intelligent person. And what qualities do you think a genius has? A genius must have very many talents or gifts. So the qualities should have a strong desire to work hard, devotion to God, ability to judge, willingness to take chances, determination, outgoingness, ability to communicate, patience, perception, perfectionism, sense of humor, adaptability, curiosity, idealism, imagination. These are some of the qualities of a genius. So mostly all of these qualities Albert Einstein had. We shall now read about a young German civil servant who took the world by storm about 100 years ago. In the summer of 1905, the 26-year-old published in quick succession 4 groundbreaking papers. about light, the motion of particles, the electrodynamics of moving bodies and energy. So this is about Albert Einstein. At the age of 26, in 1905, he published in quick succession, one after the other, four groundbreaking. Groundbreaking means completely new and pioneering. Pioneering for the first time in this groundbreaking purpose. And it was about light, the motion of particles, the electrodynamics of moving bodies and energy. His work took up only a few pages in scientific journals, but changed forever our understanding of space, time and the entire cosmos. Cosmos is the universe. And transformed the name Einstein into a synonym for genius. So that is his achievements in life. 50 years after his death, Albert Einstein's genius still reigns. So it is even today it is a part of our studies in physics and all whatever he has invented. Albert Einstein was born on 14th March 1879 in the German city of Ulm. Without any indication that he was destined for greatness. On the contrary, his mother thought Albert was a freak. To her, his head seemed much too large. So Albert Einstein was born on 14th March 1879. In the German city of Ulm. Nobody knew that he would become a great genius in the future. Nobody, because no great people are born with greatness. It is through their hard work they become great persons. So Albert Einstein was born as a normal child and he had a normal school life. And later on, only because of his hard work and other different qualities, he became a great person. On the contrary, means quite the reverse, his mother thought Albert was a freak. Freak means a person who is unusual and doesn't behave, look or think like others. That means some physical abnormality was seen. His head was rather big in size according to his body. So his mother thought that he was a freak. At the age of 2½, Einstein still wasn't talking. When he finally did learn to speak, he uttered everything twice. So at the age of 2½, Einstein still was in it. So till the age of 2½, he was not speaking. And once he started speaking, he started uttering everything twice. Uttering means speaking. Einstein did not know what to do with other children, and his playmates called him Brother Boring because he was not much mingling with his playmates. He kept him apart, away from the playmates. So, and not only that, he was repeating whatever he was saying, he was repeating twice. So people or the playmates called him Brother Boring. So the youngest played by himself much of the time. He especially loved mechanical toys. So he liked to, when he was small, as a little boy, he liked to spend time alone. He never mingled with his playmates, his friends, and he used to play alone, and he especially he loved mechanical toys. Looking at his newborn sister Maja, he said to her, said, "Fine, but where are her wheels?" So when he got a little sister, he was asking his mother, where are her wheels? A headmaster once told his father that what Einstein chose as a profession wouldn't matter because he will never make a success at anything. So his headmaster, when he was studying in a in his early studies, maybe in a high school or a elementary as a student, he told the headmaster told his father that whatever profession he may undertake, he will never make a success at anything. He is going to be a failure everywhere. Einstein began learning to play the violin at the age of 6 because his mother wanted him to. He later became a gifted amateur violinist, maintaining this skill throughout his life. So at the because of the insistence of his mother, he learned violin and he became a great violinist. And later on, he became a gifted amateur. Amateur means doing something for personal enjoyment rather than as a profession. As a profession, going around and giving program, he was not interested in that. But he learned violin well and he became a famous violinist. And he maintaining the skill throughout his life. He was playing it throughout his life. But Albert Einstein was not a bad people. Albert Einstein was not a bad people means he was a good student. He was good at studies. He went to high school in Munich in Germany, where Einstein's family had moved when he was 15 months old and scored good marks in almost every subject. So he went to high school. He studied in Munich in Germany, where Einstein's family had moved when he was 15 months old. That is, 15 months means almost 1.5 years. And scored good marks in almost every subject. That means he was a very good student. He scored good marks in every subject. Einstein hated the school's regimentation and often clashed with his teachers. So he hated school's regimentation means rules and regulations, order or discipline taken to an extreme. So in the school, the headmaster and the teachers were very strict. They had a good discipline that he did not like, and often he clashed with his teachers. He had a difference of opinion and conflict with his teachers. At the age of 15, Einstein felt so stifled that he left the school for good. For good means permanently or forever. So till the age of 15 he studied, but before completing his high school studies, at the age of 15, Einstein felt so stifled. Stifled means unable to breathe or suffocated. He felt because of the strict rules of the school, he felt suffocated, and he left the school for good means he left the school forever. The previous year, Albert's parents had moved to Milan and left their son with relatives. So before, that means before he left the school, the previous year, the Albert's parents there shifted to Milan and they put him with his relatives. After prolonged discussion, Einstein got his wish to continue his education in German-speaking Switzerland in a city which was more liberal than Munich. He was not very happy to continue his studies in Munich in Germany, but though he was in his relatives' house, after having long discussion, long discussion with his parents and relatives, and all, finally he got permission to continue his studies in German-speaking Switzerland, where it was more liberal than Munich school. Einstein was highly gifted in mathematics and interested in physics. And after finishing school, he decided to study at a university in Zurich. Zurich is in Switzerland. So Einstein was highly gifted. He was very much interested in mathematics and physics. And after finishing his high school studies, he decided to study at the university in Zurich. But science wasn't the only thing that appealed to the dashing young man with the walrus mustache. So the science, not only science was very appealing, or he was attracted only, not only for science, but this dashing young man, dashing means very stylish and handsome young man with the walrus mustache. Look at the picture, his mustache. A long, thick, drooping mustache. Walrus means a long, thick, drooping mustache. So, he was not only interested in science, but he had some other interest also. He also felt a special interest in a fellow student, Mileva Merik, whom he found to be a clever creature. So, he had a special interest with one of his classmates, whose name is Mileva Merik. And he found her as a clever creature, a clever person. This same Serb had come to Switzerland because the university in Zurich was one of the few in Europe where women could get degrees. This young Serb means she is an inhabitant of Serbia. She is from Serbia country, Serbia. That's why it is said that this young Serb, she had come to Switzerland because only few university they provided the chance for the women to complete their degree. So it was a university where women were allowed to do their degrees. Einstein saw in her an ally against the Philistines, those people in his family and at the university with whom he was constantly at odds. So Einstein saw in her an ally means a friend or an associate. So he was like, she had a similar liking and disliking for liking him, because Einstein disliked, he had a Philistine means people who do not like arts, literature or music. He was not much interested in this. So his family people and those who were at the university, they were also Philistines. So they were they had liking for this, and but he was against them. Similar quality she too had. They were similar in this quality. That is, he was also against the Philistines, also the people who liked art, literature and music. So he was in constantly at odds means he was always against them. There was a difference of opinion and there was a conflict between the university with his family people and the university where the people were against him. The couple fell in love. This Mileva Merik and Einstein fell in love. Letters survive in which they put their affection into words, mixing science with tenderness. So even today, letters survive in which they put their affection into words while mixing science with tenderness. Wrote Einstein, how happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought our work on relativity to a victorious conclusion. So, Einstein wrote to her, how happy and proud I shall be when we both have brought out work on relativity. They both were working and trying to bring out papers on a relativity. So when it come to a victorious conclusion, he will be very happy and proud, he wrote in his letter. In 1900, at the age of 21, Albert Einstein was a university graduate and unemployed. So in 1900, at the age of 21, he completed his graduation. Albert Einstein was a university graduate, but he was unemployed. He worked as a teaching assistant, gave private lessons, and finally secured a job in 1902 as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern. So after he worked as a teaching assistant, gave private lessons. First he was giving private lessons, and finally he got a job in 1902 after 2 years. And his job was as a technical expert in the patent office in Bern, Germany. While he was supposed to be assessing other people's inventions, Einstein was actually developing his own ideas in secret. Here, patent means a document which gives the rights of an invention to an inventor. So, while he was supposed to, as a technical expert, he was working. While he was assessing other people's inventions, he was developing his own ideas in secret and inventing new ideas and new things. He is said to have jokingly called his desk drawer at work the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. So he used to call his desk drawer as the Bureau of Theoretical Physics. Though he said it as a joke, it was really taking place, because while he was assessing the inventions of other people, he was trying to make his own experiments and bring out new experiments and bring out new theories. One of the famous papers of 1905 was Einstein's special theory of relativity, according to which time and distance are not absolute. So one of the famous papers of Einstein was in 1905, he brought out a new theory, special theory of relativity. It was according to which the time and the distance are not absolute. Not absolute means not complete. Indeed, two perfectly accurate clocks will not continue to show the same time if they come together again after a journey, if one of them has been moving very fast relative to the other. So he brought the example, two perfectly accurate clocks will not continue to show the same time if they come together again after a journey, if one of them has been moving very fast relative to the other. So after a long journey, if we bring these two clocks together, so it may not be of the same time, he says. From this followed the world's most famous formula, which describes the relationship between mass and energy. So from this he brought out the famous formula, that is E is equal to mc square. For that he brings an example. In this mathematical equation, E stands for energy, M for mass, and C for the speed of the light in a vacuum about 3 lakh kilometers. Vacuum is empty or no air. Another example, in order to prove this, he brings out another example. When you sit with a nice girl for 2 hours, it seems like 2 minutes. When you sit on a hot stove for 2 minutes, it seems like 2 hours. That is relativity, Albert Einstein. So the example is very clear. When we sit with our loved ones whom we love to talk and see, so time will pass very fast. Whereas when we don't like, here example of stove, sit on a hot stove for 2 minutes, we feel like boring and it will look like 2 hours. So students, here I will stop. Read the lesson. Write down the meanings that are given in the textbook. So thank you students. Have a nice day.